While it's true that I'm from a suburb of the City of Angels, today I live above San Francisco. And up here, it's a community of the New Age, for sure. And of course, that's why I'm here. This is New Jerusalem. And the next 1,000 years of religion are going to come from this place. That's my personal feeling on the matter. But you don't have to agree with me, obviously. At any rate, there are a lot of people here who I like to call spiritualites. Not spiritualites in the sense that they're spiritualites, but spiritual light. And that has multiple meanings because of Kabbalism. Light, obviously, can mean what some people believe it means, to say that it is the greatest of all God's creations or something like that. Other people understand that light is an insulting and quipping remark to say that you're not very heavy, not very deep, and that your experience and your knowledge with these things does not go very far. You're kind of you're a lightweight. You can't handle very much. No food for one day and too much sitting in one position and you're gonna freak out. Me too. Okay, but still, there are some things about all of this that are very interesting to me. And one of them is that the people who are characterized mostly by this New Age are some of the greatest people who have ever lived on the face of the earth, first of all, let me tell you. They have so much love for things. But they have a great amount of difficulty processing their hate. They have a great amount of difficulty processing the things that flow through them, which do not agree with their constructed sense of morality that says they must always have right speech, right action, right thought, blah, 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 8-point-fold that. They didn't know anything about that, really. That's okay. And it's good. The world would be better if people were that way only, but they're not. And the world's not that way. It is nice for people to say things like, oh, you should never eat meat. You should never kill anything. Ahimsa, ahimsa, ahimsa. No pain, no suffering, ever. We're all going to live in a fanciful paradise. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very lovely. I agree. I want to go to this place too. But it's not here now. It's not here now. And it's not been here ever. There are all kinds of different takes on the Ascended Master's teachings. The most respected and most widely circulated Ascended Master is definitely Siddhartha. Siddhartha is the greatest, and that's true. But he doesn't give the same message that Krishna gave. And he doesn't give the same message that Jesus gave, even though they're equated to each other very often. He also doesn't give the message of Lao Tzu. I would say that the message of Lao Tzu, Jesus, and Krishna are all much, much closer together. The Buddhist message is without almost any darkness. Doesn't have any pain in it. It doesn't have any suffering. The first red type word in the Gospels, the canonized Gospels, in the Gospel of Matthew, the first red type word, which is the first word coming out of Jesus' mouth, is suffer. There's nothing about Yeshua that says, avoid suffering. Disattach yourself from the suffering of the world. Nothing. Yes, Yeshua tells you to love your neighbor. And yes, the Buddha told you to do the same thing. But the Buddha's take on suffering is to eliminate it by disattaching yourself to all of the things which created. This is a very good trick. It's very worth pursuing. Everyone on earth should know that, and everyone on earth should honestly keep it in mind. It has nothing to do with God, and it has nothing to do with anything fancy. It's a good trick for human beings to keep their stress down and keep their heart rate low. But Yeshua's message is different. Yeshua's message is suffer. Suffer. Make suffering your ally and make it your friend. This is how you have your yes and your no.